Hello all. Welcome to an incredibly special day, it looks like. From the morning I have been receiving messages about the special nature of this day. Well, I'll have to make you a list for sure. But first, you're tuning in to the Audible Weed Walk episode 41. This is Nina, welcoming you all. Now, what's so special about today? In this day and age, I think, the fact that I'm still feeling well and talking to you, and if you're feeling well too, or getting better, it is already quite special, isn't it? But no, I'm talking about festivities and celebrations. We need some of those also. Yesterday, of course, was Eid. Eid Mubarak to you all. Today is Akthi or Akshay Tritiya. Turns out that this day many special things happened which are to be celebrated. I'm picking and choosing a few for you. Today is the day River Ganga, on request of King Bhagiratha, had descended on the earth according to the Hindu mythology. It also marks the day Rishi Vyasa, also called Vedavyas, because he had compiled Vedas also, had started authoring the epic Mahabharata by narrating it to his scribe, Lord Ganesha himself. I always knew that Akshaya Tritiya is considered a good day for initiating something, in a way, a new beginning. But let's turn our attention to the foodie culture. In East Bengal, today is the day to start making Aam Kashundi. You know, Kashundi is a mustard spread. There are mustard spreads of various kinds all across the world. You know, the Dijon mustard, the English mustard. But in India, for some reason, the only mustard spread or preserve, rather, you have traditionally is Kashundi, which comes originally from East Bengal. And on this day, there is a version of Kashundi that is made, which is along with mango, and that's why it's called Aam Kashundi. So on this day, the people starts making traditionally the Aam Kashundi, incorporating mango with the mustard preserve. This new beginning, distinctly marking when to start using a certain produce, you know, like mango, comes perhaps from our tribal culture. Today is the beginning of the new year for the Bhil people. Bhil are the largest group of indigenous peoples who are in India. They live traditionally in the western and the northern belts, like part of Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, and there is a population who also live in Tripura, which is bordering Bangladesh. This is their new year, or Pandam, which literally means inauguration. As part of the tribal culture, the festival seeks the permission of Mother Nature to start using the forest produce that sustain their lives and livelihoods, such as Markat or mango, Maria, which refers to the plants in the grass family. Perhaps this refers to all the grains and millets that used to be grown or still currently grown in the forest as part of shifting cultivation. Then there is char or chironji. For those who are not familiar with this, it refers to seeds of the tree called Buchanania lanzan. All parts of this tree are medicinal. Seeds are famous chironji, which are like tiny little nuts. They are eaten raw or cooked. Also, the fruits, fresh or dried, are eaten, and the oil is extracted from the seeds and eaten. The other plant that is celebrated in the Pandam is Tendu, which is Diospyros melanoxylon. Again, highly medicinal. However, the leaves are used in making the covering layer for bidi, you know, the local cigarette that is smoked. And of course, there is Mahua or Madhuka longifolia. The flowers are collected to eat as a sweetener. Of course, the famous alcoholic drink is made out of it. It is mixed with grains and eaten, as a chapati or roti, which is a flatbread, to gain strength. and the seeds called Torah in the Bhil language. And I was used to the Saura people, and they call it Tulo, are used for extracting oil. And the oil is used as a cooking medium and for other medicinal purpose. Mahua is certainly the symbol of tribal life and well-being anywhere in India. Similarly, festivities exist, I would assume, among all indigenous communities. Among Gond, I got to know, who is the, another indigenous group of indigenous people. They have something called Bija Pandam. Bija means seeds. It involves collecting and saving grains that will be sown soon to celebrate them and to seek their permission that they would be sown. Isn't that awesome? I would love to read and also find out in person more about such celebrations when opportunity offers again. This is the sort of connection with nature we need to reinforce where it exists and inculcate elsewhere as we carry on with our lives after the pandemic becomes manageable. So last week I had talked about a bit about the supplements and the latest findings, how the result shows that they make significant difference, but only for a small percentage of people, in preventing COVID-19 virus infection compared to those who did not take any supplements. And this marginal but significant difference showed up in women only. But what I was really impressed about is the number of people who were part of this test. More than 300,000 people were part of the study in UK, which means almost in a kind of 50%, not quite, of them were part of the control group, and the rest were part of the experiment, those who were taking supplements. So this number was 45,000 in USA and 27,000 in Sweden. It's a lot, but this is, you know, for this kind of study and to apply to people, this kind of numbers are needed. Also needed that the study, whatever it is, whatever the result is, you know, in this case the result is probably not what was one was looking for, is actually published in a peer-reviewed journal. These are the basic requirements for the scientific approach. However, I had also highlighted how the doctors also feel that one needs to be remain a little open about the use of supplements, just because, you know, some things which are supposed to be good for you may be good for you, even if it is not good for a particular things that has been tested, or perhaps our way of testing yet hasn't quite embraced that quality. So let's be open. This week you must have read about or even found around you two nature-based supplements that have been recommended by the government's Ayush ministry. One is called Ayush 64, the other is called Kabasura Kudinir. Now, I could be murdering the pronunciation, but sorry about that. Kudi means to drink, and Nir is water in Tamil, so Kudinir means drinking water. But I'll come to that. Kabasura Kudinir later. One of the two supplements is Ayush 64. I'm guessing this has been kind of put together as a supplement for this occasion. It involves four plants, Alstonia scholaris, which in Bengali we call Chatim, or it's called Saptaparna, Pali Mara in Tamil, Katuki, or Katuka Rogini in Tamil, and it's called Picoriza Kuroa. Then Kuberaksha, this is used to be called Cisalpinia Crista, now it's called Gilandina Bonduk. And the fourth one is Svetania Chireta, the wild weedy plant represented here. It's called Chireta, very bitter but extremely medicinal. But I'm not going to spend too much time on this, because this is really none of them are edible per se. Also, I read a newspaper article which kind of reported on this Ayush 64 and said that the results were not yet published, which needs to be in a peer-reviewed journal. And the study apparently included 70 people each, 17 control, 17 experiment, and this was done in three different places. So, how many replicates? I'm switching my hat to be, I teach a course during for one semester in Oroville itself on biodiversity and land stewardship, and there we cover how to set up experiment design and replications so that we don't pseudo replicate, and so this is a kind of a nice example for that. But let's get back to what we were talking. What the circulation from the ministry highlighted, and I would like to highlight that whatever it is, if you plan to take this or not, it should be taken in adjunct, or along with, and not instead of the standard treatment. Very important part. And as a preventative of This should be taken as a preventative for patients who are not showing any symptoms, want to take it as a preventative, or have mild symptoms, and should be taken under the strict guidance of a doctor. So, don't please indulge in ordering it online and trying it out, because there is no need. What we can do is to boost ourselves, eat healthy, eat the right things, and it's okay. So I was more interested in the other supplement, which is called Kabasura Kudineed. As I said, Kudineed means drinking water. But what does Kabasura mean? Kaba is refers to the kapha dosha. You know that this time of the year one has to manage the kapha and eat cool and light and prevent kapha accumulation. Remember my previous podcast? One has to eat bitters, avoid too much fermented food, eat a bit of ginger maybe, increase the agni in your stomach so that it digests better. If this kapha be considered as a asura or demon, that's what is referred to as the kapasura. And a portion of the wild uncultivated greens has been prepared to keep it under control. And this is what the kapasura kudineer is. But yet, again, this too must be taken under the supervision of the doctor. And this is a medicine. So I thought, why not look at the list of what gets into the Kapasura Kudineer? It took me a while because there's a lot of discrepancies between lists and all that. And let's see what we can eat on a regular basis in our diet. No, we will just incorporate them and get the goodness and not have to take it as a medicine. So there is of course dried ginger and clove from our pantry. There is a tree involved, which is the yellow myrobalan, which is Terminalia cebula. We all know it as a hartiki. It can be easily, you can just scrape the surface and put it in the boiling water, makes an excellent tea. What I'll do is I'll probably go over a few of them each. Once I had promised that I will take one plant each week and highlight it a little bit, so I will do that with this list of plants. Then there is of course Cedar acuta and Cedar cordifolia. These grows it's called bala in Sanskrit. It's this grows in profusion around here, but this is not edible, so let's forget it. Then there is of course Piper longum, Tippali, wild weedy. Wonderful green. The rest are actually all wild woody plants. Wow. Some grows around here, which I'll mention, and some doesn't grow around here. So there is Tippali, it definitely grows around here. Adathoda, its Tamil name is Adathoda, Bengali name is Bashok. It's called Justicia adathoda. Then there is velvet leaf, which is Cisampelos pereira. There's a lot of confusion with this name. It is called Vatta Thirupi in Tamil, except that there is another plant called Vatta Thirupi in Tamil, which is also edible, highly medicinal. So let's not be confused. In Hindi, it's called Laghupata, except that there is another plant which is called Rajapatha, and sometimes only Patha is used for both of them. What confusion! Then there is the English word called velvet leaf. Again, another plant is called velvet leaf also. So let's stick to the scientific name, Cisampelos pereira, which grows in profusion around where we are in South India, and this is often mixed up with guduchi or giloy, which is also in the list. So the easy way to actually differentiate between guduchi or giloy, which is Tinosporia cordifolia, with this particular plant, is that if you take the cross section, the guduchi plant will look like a little cartwheel. So that's a tip for you to know. So now going to the, so my plant of the week is this Cisampelos pereira. It is a this herb is used in curing fever, intestinal worm, reduces hemorrhage, and it has almost like a 30 different ailments it can actually address when you are taking it as a medicine. But we are not taking it as a medicine. It is also, research has shown that it has quite high antioxidant activities. Good for you. Needs to be eaten cooked, not too much. So what you can do is take a few leaves. If you are taking all parts of this plant is edible. So all parts of this plant is medicinal. So what you can do is take a few leaves, make it a tea if you want. Take a few leaves. What I really enjoy is putting it as a pot herb. Like, you know, you're making a soup, just add a few handful of leaves in this. I did exactly that for yesterday for my dinner. And then, of course, I read a paper that this plant has, it's high in pectin. So it's called Creo Manoi in Thai language. And so they have extracted the pectin of this and to use a dessert, a famous Thai dessert called Lot Chong. It's, you know, very gelatinous, jelly-like dessert, which is sweet and with coconut milk. It's not very healthy. So in order to make it healthy, they have started using, a research actually have recommended using the pectin extract from this. So a pectin extract may be an industrial process. What we can do is to cut up these leaves and use it, and you know, when you're making a dessert like a kind of a payasa or a tapioca pudding or whatever you are making with coconut milk if you want to keep it vegan. And I haven't tried this, but I'm going to try this. So let me know if you have tried, and send me a message in my email address, which is edibleweed@gmail.com. And I will see you next time. Take care, be well, be safe.